But first, we're going to look at some flower pots in Rottingdean. Surely that's a good thing, or maybe not? Mark Walker.
It's normally a good thing, but not when they're in the road, potentially, because we've seen it at the central Brighton, in and around London Road, where there's these plants, and they're called planters. I mean, we say flower pots, they're a bit more than that, but people refer to them as flower pots. They're kind of traffic calming measures, really. You've seen them just by the level there, just up from the level, just off of London Road. There's some in the road there, and they're just basically to calm traffic.
Right.
Slow traffic.
But Rottingdean High Street is a very narrow street.
It is narrow.
So surely there might be some issues. Now
well, yeah, there are narrow. I mean, it's so that it's a calm, slow traffic down there. Cause it, as you say, it's a narrow street. So the idea, I guess, is to keep the pedestrians safe because there's people on either side of pavement. They're walking down the shops there. We've heard from Elif Koza before. She runs a fashion boutique there. And basically, you know, these traffic calm measures are meant to slow down traffic so that everyone can use that street, you know, at the same time.
Right.
But in practice, that doesn't always work in practice because obviously it can be a bit dangerous having obstacles in the street. As we know from speed bumps, they can damage cars, can't they? But they serve a purpose. These traffic calming measures have been slightly controversial as part of a wider grievance on for people around in and around that street. Their grievance is that it's high levels of pollution there.
Elif and other people, does she represent a group of people who are very unhappy with
yes.
it?
Yes, right. As we heard from Elif, Elif is saying that she's done a petition which is due to be heard in front of Brighton and Hove City Council on the 17th of March. She's got a whole group of people, they're saying, have a look again at these traffic calming measures, have a look again in the high street, rethink it, because we don't think what you've put in place there works. I think from the Brighton Hove City Council point of view, they've got to weigh it up, haven't they? They've got to weigh up the kind of the safety of the public, but also drivers as well. It's always a difficult balance.
Okay, maybe we can find out about what happened after the petition has been presented.
Exactly, on the 17th of March.
Thank you so much.
No problem.